Hi everyone, in this video we're going to talk about using a 3D reference in your formula. So I want to show you how that works and what is meant by a 3D reference. Okay, so let's get started. So in your exercise on step 6, we need to figure out our net income. So our net income is actually going to come from a couple different things. It's going to be our sales minus our expenses, but also we have a tax that we need to figure out as well. So for each month, you can see that we have a tax, and they have this set up on a different worksheet in our workbook. So that's where the 3D reference comes in. A 3D reference means that in my formula, I'm going to reference something that's on a different worksheet than the one that I'm currently working on. You can also do a 3D reference to a different workbook, but in this case, we're just referencing a different worksheet. So let's get started on our formula. So of course, we start with our equal sign, and we use, here we're going to use a parentheses to kind of group things together to make sure that our math is figured out in the correct way. I'll probably post another video about mathematical order of operation, but in your book it talks about that, so please make sure to read that because it is very important in the world of Excel. So here I want to use B5, so I'll just go ahead and click on that. And then I'm adding B6. Now, you're probably sitting there thinking, why didn't they just use B7, which is the total? And yes, they could have done it that way. I think in the book, they're just trying to show you, using the parentheses and that type of thing, but we could have just said B7. But we're just going to kind of follow along with the way the book has it, just so you know that this is an option as well. Okay, so now we have these grouped together with parentheses. And then what we're going to do is we want to subtract out our total expenses. So first I need to type in a minus sign because you need an operator in between the, in this formula that we're building. So now I want to click on B14. So I have the total sales, which is the B5 plus B6 minus B14. And then the last thing that I want to do is I also want to subtract out my taxes because unfortunately we do have to pay taxes to, Uncle Sam, so to speak. So that's always something that is subtracted out. So in this case, now I will go ahead, my taxes are on this other sheet. So my first thing that I want to do is press the minus keys to start that part of the formula. And next I'm going to click on the CastLake tax worksheet. Let's take a look up here in our formula bar. You can see that this is kind of interesting. Now I have CastLake tax in apostrophe and then an exclamation point. So if you ever see that in your formula, that's telling you that the information is coming from a different worksheet, and it tells you the name of the worksheet. Okay, so we're going to get this information from B5 on our CastLake tax worksheet. So you can see that I just clicked on B5 and that included it into the formula. And that's it. That's all we need. So we're taking our total sales minus our expenses minus our taxes. And that completes the formula. So if I'm done, I just need to press the Enter key. Notice it takes me back over to my original sheet because this is where the information is ending up. I'm just going over to CastLake Tax to grab the information that I needed in order to complete this formula. So again, let's take another look up here at the formula bar. You can see that we built the formula with the total sales minus the total expenses minus the taxes, which we grabbed from the other worksheet in cell B5. Now, in this case, let's go ahead and just use our fill handle to fill on over, and that looks pretty good. So, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.